Hello, good afternoon, friends. So today we'll be starting. I'll explain sum of subset problem. You are able to see the Excel sheet? Share.
Yes.
Hello. Hello, students. Are you able to see the Excel sheet?
Yes.
Yeah. Fine. So the problem name is sum of subset problem. So here, a set will be given to you. Example, here I have taken a set as 1, 2 and 3. And they will tell you to check form subsets. So a set will be given to you. They will tell you to form subsets. So, but for forming the subsets, they'll give a bounding function. What is bounding function in backtracking means bounding function or rules. They will call it as. So for forming subsets, they are giving a rules. Now what is that rules is the sum of subset should be equal to 6. Suppose for this example or 3. Suppose for this example, I have taken it as 3. Now using this set 1, 2, and 3. You have two solutions. Using this set, you have two solutions. That is, take 1 and 2, or one more solution is 3. So 1 plus 2 gives answer as 3, and also directly you can 3. These are the two subsets. So this is the set. I'll highlight with green color. The set has three elements. The elements are 1, 2, and 3. And the subset, I am forming subset, that is one subset is having the element 1 and 2, the other subset is having the element 3. Now I have followed the bounding function or rules, whatever the rules they have told me to form the subset. Now I have two subsets here. This is subset 1. This is subset 2, and this is the set given to me. Now the subset 1 is satisfying the condition. If I add the two elements in subset 1, it is giving us 3. If I add 2 plus 1, so it is giving the answer as 3. So again, subset 2, it is giving the answer as 3. There is only one element, 3. So the condition is form a subset such that the sum of the elements, the sum of the elements in that subset, if you add it, is equal to 3. So two subsets are possible here. Like this, they can give you any problem and tell you to find out the solution. Now today I'll be going to explain one simple problem, and one assignment problem I'll be giving it to you for assignment. So you can take your own time and do it. Not a problem that you need not submit me and all. Just you can take your own time and do it. Just for you to understand. So now going to the problem, I have already solved the problem here. If you see here, I have meant your solution here. There is a solution here, that is 3, and a solution towards your right hand side, that is here, that is also answer is 3. So what is my answer should come as 3. Subset answer. So a set is given, subset should be identified. The subset should be in a way such that the sum of the elements in that subset should be give the answer as 3. Now already I have write out the 3. Yesterday I forgot to tell one thing. These 3 are called as state space 3. These trees are called as state space tree. Now example, in the exam they'll ask, write a state space tree for 4 cross 4 queens problem. Means yesterday I wrote and showed, you know, I derived a tree, no? That tree, if you draw it, that is enough. Now, today for the sum of subset problem, they will ask a question, draw a state space tree for the sum or subset problem, and they will give the problem for you. What is the problem they will give? Only two items, two information they will give. One is the set, and one is you should form a subset, and the condition that should be satisfied is this sum. The subset should satisfy this sum. Okay, that is the problem they will give. Rest everything is the solution. Now if you see, I am going to delete all these answers and show you how did I got this answer. Okay, so I delete this. Just be observing. I deleted all the elements. I delete. All the elements I delete. Now, you just assume we have started with 0 and 6. What is that 0 and 6? First, you should know. Now, these two boxes are there, which I highlighted with yellow color. Like this, everywhere there are boxes. And right hand side child, I have highlighted with this color to make you clear. Left hand side child, I have highlighted with yellow color. Right hand side child, I have highlighted with some light purple color. Just to make a difference. So what is in these two boxes? This is the left. This is the left part. This is the right part. Okay. Now, this left part tells you items considered. Items considered. So left part tells you items considered. Right part tells you remaining weight. Remaining weight. So right part tells you remaining weight. So every box, see, there are two data. One is left hand side, one more is right hand side. So left hand side tells you the items considered. So what are the items here? You can say in the set there are three elements. 1, 2, and 3. So the items that we can consider is these three items, any of these three items. And the right hand side is the remaining items, the sum of the remaining items. So keep this in mind. Now I'll explain how we do it. First box. Now each time if I do, I'll change the color and go. Now just assume newly I will teach you now. Starting from here. So I'll use which color? This light red color. So this color I will use. So now, why did I put 0 here? Because I am not considering any items first time. How many items are there here? 1, 2 and 3. These are the items. These are the items. Now, I don't consider any items. So the remaining, what are the remaining items? If I ask you, you should say, since I am not considering any item, so the remaining items are 1 plus 2, 1 plus 2 plus 3. That comes out to be answer as 6. That is why I have written 6 on the right hand side. So now I am speaking about this box, first box. The students will get confused why sir is written 0 here. And right hand side, why sir has written 6 here. Now, here why I have written 0 is, I have not considered any items. How many items are there here? There are totally 3 items. The items are 1, 2 and 3. It can be any other numbers given also. It can be 10, 15, 30 also. But there are only 3 items given here, 1, 2 and 3. For simplicity, for make you to understand, for make the students understand in a simple way, I have taken simple numbers. So let the tree is small and the first let the students understand. So I have taken simple numbers. Okay, 1, 2 and 3. So in the set, elements 1, 2 and 3 are there. So in the first box, 0 and 6 is there. The 0 is because I have not considered any items. Why 6 means, If I don't consider any item, then all the items are remaining items. Remaining items. I have not considered any items. So all the items are remaining. So the sum of that 3 plus 2 plus 1, the total sum is 6. Like that, I got the first box. Coming to the next box, I will highlight with this same color. Whichever, now I am highlighting with this light color, like a peach color. That and all, I am trying to solve and come out with the final tree. Okay, final tree is what I shown in the beginning itself. Now I one by one I will change the color and so. Now, in the now this box left hand side, I am considering one item, the first item, with item one, with item one. What will be the answer here? Left hand side and right hand side. Now students, see it, observe it very clearly. What will be the answer here? With item one. So item I am considering is one. In the right hand side box, what will be? Suppose if I consider item one, I am considering item one. So in the remaining items, what are there? In the remaining items, two and three are remaining. I am considering item one. The remaining items are what are there? There are two items remaining in the set. Since I can't include one also because I am taking one. From the set, I am taking one. So remaining is what? Two and three. What is the sum? 3 plus 2. Answer is 5. Like this I got. How did I get, students? Slowly I will go one more time. Students will think why sir is telling so many times. But one reason is there, you will get confused. That is why I am telling. Afterwards, I will go a little bit fast. When I consider my first item, I have considered first item. When I consider first item from the set, the remaining items are what? 2 and 3. What is the sum of that? 2 plus 3, answer is 5. That is how I got this box. Now, I come to this box. Again, I'll highlight with a color so that you will understand where I am working out. And this is a depth first search. Backtracking is a depth first search where we go depth wise and then go back and solve the other part of the trees. Now I am in this. Now if you see the peach color, the light color here, left hand side. So I see with item two and with item one. With item one already I have considered. That is why 1 and 5 I have got. Now plus 2. With item 2 also. Now if I consider item 2 also, then what will you do? You will write 2 here. No, it is wrong. You will write 2 here and the remaining item is 1 and 3. So 3 plus 1 answer is 4. You will write like this. But the answer is wrong. Why answer is wrong? Because when I come below, already I have considered item 1. See, already I have item 1 I have considered. So now when you take, what is this? No, W item 2 I have written with item 2. With item 2. So with item 2, previously I have considered item 1 also. So now what the two items I have considered? 1 and 2. 1 and 2. So what is the items now I have considered? 1 and 2. What is the remaining item? 3. So if I considered item 1 and 2, so I considered item 1 and 2. What is the sum? And the sum is 3. That is how I got this answer. Now, sir, students will ask, why is that 3 and 3? I'm not able to understand. See, now this first time I considered item 1. And I considered item 1. The left hand side of the box, I considered item 1. So answer is 1. The right hand side of the box, if I considered item 1, the remaining item are 2 and 3. So the sum of that is 3 plus 2, answer is 5. If I want, I will write here. 1 is considered here, 2 and 3 is considered. So 2 plus 3, I will write like this for you to understand. Well, first item is considered, then the remaining item are 2 plus 3. 2 plus 3, answer is 5. Now how did I get 3 here? First item is already present. Plus the new item which I am considering is second item. The remaining item is 3. The remaining item is 3. So 1 plus 2, the answer is 3. The remaining item is 3. Now, what is why I have written below solution? Now, students will ask, sir, why you have written here solution? I have I have got the solution. Why? Because I have achieved the sum. The sum is 3. With what items? With, now I got the first subset. Now I got the first subset. The items in the subset are 1, 2. The items in the subset are 1 and 2. If the items in the subset are 1 and 2, the sum of this 2 plus 1, the sum is 3. So I achieved the solution 3. Now this, after achieving the solution, I can proceed further also, but it is a extra work. If I proceed further, what will happen? I will show you. Now, in this, again, right hand side, with item 3. So here, the items considered are 1 plus 2 plus 3. So the answer will be, the answer will be 6. The remaining items will be 0. So I will highlight with a color. So now these are the color, which peach color, you see those boxes I have solved. So even if I get the answer as 6 with all the items, but that is not the solution, because I should, that is a set, that is not a solution. So I no need to calculate that. Once I get the answer as 3, then I can stop there. That is why I have written in green color, that is a solution. Okay, even if you go further and calculate, you will not get solution. So I can kill those children. That is what I have given here. Now see here, I will highlight it. This is a peach color. I have solved that box. This is peach color. I have solved that box. This is again a peach color. I have solved that box. Now this is a peach color. I have solved that box. See, items considered are all the 3 items. 1 plus 2 plus 3. So the total is 6. And the remaining items are 0. Now coming to the right hand side. See, here there is a left hand side child. And here also there is a right hand side child. Now again I will color this. See, now I will use different color so that you will identify what I am solving. Now I already have used each color. Now I will use this color. You should identify. I will use a green. I will use this blue color, bright blue color. Now I have come here 6 and 0, but that is not needed actually. When I got the solution, I could have stopped. I could have stopped here only, but for you to make you understand, I am telling you. If I go further also, I am not getting any solution, because the answer is 6 here, but that I should get a subset of some 3. So going back, since it is a backtracking, now I am in this 6 and 0, left hand side of the box is 6, right hand side remaining items are 0. So I am in this box. Now I am going back. When I go back, I come here. Now I come to the right hand side of the child, that is this blue color. Now I come to right hand side of the child. Now here with item 1 is there, with item 1, with item 2, but without item 3, what will be the answer? With item 1, with item 2, without item 3, what will be the answer? So with item 1 and 2 is 1 plus 2. With item 1 and 2 is 1 plus 2. That will be answer is 3. But the here remaining item are 0. Now the students will think, why sir is considering 1 plus 2 answer is 3? Then why sir has written again 0? There is 3, no. There is no 3 here. See, that is what I am saying, without item 3. Now without item 3 means I am just ignoring 3. I am just ignoring 3. If I ignore 3 with item 1 and with item 2, what is the answer? With item 1, the element, first element considered is 1. With item 2, the second item considered is 2. 1 plus 2, answer is 3. The right hand side, why I am putting a 0? All the students will say, sir, you should put 3, no? Why you are putting 0? Means, I am not considering 3 at all. See, without item 3. See, top of that, what I have written? Without item 3. I am not considering that item 3 at all. So I am putting it as 0. So now I have solved the left hand side of the child also, right hand side of the child also. I am going back. I am here now. From here again I go back. I am here now. For this particular node, see, I am highlighting again and again. For this particular node, the left hand side I have solved, but the right hand side I have not solved. So I'll come here. Now highlight with a blue color. If I highlight with a blue color, what is the answer here? Now here with item 1. So with item 1 if I take, the answer is 1 item I have considered. The remaining item are 2 and 3. So the answer is 5. Come to the right hand side without item 2. So I am not considering item 2 at all. I am not considering item 2 at all. Now here what it should come. Suppose if I don't consider item 2 at all, the items already I have considered is 1. Okay. Already I have considered is 1. Now, so I will put a 1 here. And towards the right hand side, what I will put? I will put a 3. Now students will ask why. I will tell you. See now the path. See this path with item 1. With item 1 from the set, I got the answer 1. The remaining item are 2 and 3. So I got the answer 5. Now, without item 2. With item 2, without item 2. With item 1, without item 1. With item 3, without item 3. That is how you should proceed. So with item 2 and without item 2. The left hand side is with item 2. The right hand side is without item 2. So without item 2, now I am not considering item 2 at all. Then what is the item remain? What is the item I have considered? I have considered item 1 here. So students will say, sir, you should consider 1 plus 3, no. So answer will be 4. No. Item 3, when I should consider? In my third level. Not this is my second level. Level 1, item 1, without item 1. Level 2, item 2 without item 2. Level 3 with item 1 without item 3. So I can't consider 1 plus 3 here. Okay, that is wrong. I have considered item 1. Now, without item 2, I am just ignoring item 2. Then what is the remaining item? Item only 3. That is how I got on the right hand side 3. Okay, so the item considered are till now first only one item is considered, first item. The remaining item, you will say, sir, it is 2 and 3. No, it is not 2 and 3. Without item 2 means I am just leaving off 2. So that the remaining item is 3. Coming to the next, here, this box. Again, I should highlight it with a peach color. This color. Coming to this box. Now, with item 1, with item 1 is already I have considered before. I have ignored item 2. Now I am considering item 3. 1 plus 3. So I am considering 1 plus 3. So the answer is 4. The remaining item are 0. The remaining item are 0. Now come to this box. Again with a blue color. Again with a blue color. Now in this, see from the top, this arrow mark with item 1, coming to this box, this arrow mark without item 2, we came to this box. Now this right hand side, this arrow mark, observe this arrow mark, without item 3. So in this part, we are considering item 1, without item 2, without item 3. So if I consider item 1, the answer is 1. Now here, the students will say the answer is 5. Because immediately they will say 5. Because we have considered item 1 and the remaining item are 2 and 3. It is 5. But it is actually wrong. The answer is 0 should come here. Why 0 means with item 1, one item I have considered, that is the first item. Then see the path. See this arrow mark without item 2 and see this arrow mark without item 3. If I ignore item 2 and ignore item 3, then how will answer 5 will come? So the only item I considered is 1 and the remaining items are 0. Now all the left hand side of the tree I have completed. Now going to this side, going to this side. I have highlighted with this color. Now, without item 1. Now, I have started with 0 and 6. 0 and 6 I have started. Without item 1 means I am ignoring item 1 only. Okay, I am ignoring item 1 only. So, if I ignore the item 1, okay, so what are the items I have considered? Nothing. So, the items considered are nothing. So, 0. What are the remaining items? 2 plus 3, answer is 5. 2 plus 3, answer is 5. See, I started with 0 and 6. 0, why did I start? I have not considered any item. The remaining items are 1, 2, and 3. 6. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. Now, see the right hand side without item 1. So, now if I ignore item 1, I am not considering item 1 at all. I am not considering item 1 at all. So, here I am not considering item 1 and still 2 and 3 in the level 1 I cannot take. So, the answer is I am not considering any item. So, 0 here. Item 1 I am ignoring without item 1. So, the remaining items are 2 plus 3. So, the answer is 5. Now, coming to this part. So, with item 2. So, if I consider with item 2, without this part, how did I got? From without item 1, I got this. Then coming here, then come to this arrow mark with item 2. So, if I consider with item 2, I will take 2 here. Already, you know, I have ignored item 1. Now, I have considered with item 2. So, I have taken 2 here. What is the remaining item? It is 3. Now, I am coming to this. Okay. Now, with item 3. So, already I have considered item number 2 plus I have considered item number 3 also. So, 2 plus 3, the answer is 5. The remaining items are 0. Now, consider this part. See, you have this is actually a backtracking. So, how will you go? After 5 and 0, after 5 comma 0, you go back. This part, go back, you come here. There is a right side. You come to this arrow mark, fill this boxes. Now, to fill this boxes, what and all you should consider? Come from beginning. So, here, without item 1. Then, how did you come? With item 2. Then, this arrow mark. Without item 3. This is what? Actually, without item 3. Clearly, I have written here, see, without item 3. This is W slash O is without. IT is, I have written short form, item 3. So, now, you are not considering item number 1 also. You are not considering item number 3 also. See this arrow mark? Without item number 1, but with item number 2, but without item number 3. So, only the item you have considered is 2, and the remaining weight is 0. Because you have not considered item number 1 also, you have not considered item number 3 also. So, the remaining weight is 0. So, now again we go back. This path we came, we go back, we come here. Again go back. See, it's a backtracking. So, go back, we came here. And then this arrow mark. When we come to this arrow mark, I will highlight again with a blue color. And I highlight with a blue color. Now, here how did we come to this box? How did we come to this box? We came from this one. Without item 1. Without item 2. So both the items I am not considering. Both the items I am not considering. So if I don't consider both the items. So answer is 0 here. The remaining item is only 3. The remaining item is 3. Okay. Now after this box. I come to this box. So. How did I come to this box? This color I have highlighted. See, how did I come to this box? Without item 1, without item 2, with item 3. See, this WITEM 3 means with item 3. So, with item 3 means I have got 3 here. And since I have not considered item 1 and not considered item 2 also, the answer is 0 here. So, now I have written below that solution. I have got a solution. So, what is the next subset? I'll write the subset here. What is the next subset did I get? that is only with item 3. See, without item 1, without item 2, but with item 3. I got one more subset. So this one subset I got, this one subset I got. Now go back again. How did we come here? Using this part, go back here, come to this. Now, without item 1, without item 2, without item 3. So the answer is 0. We are not considering any item. So here also it is 0. We are not considering any item. So this is what the two solutions we got. I will highlight fully it with a green color. So the first solution is this one. The second solution is this one. The second solution is this one. So see, the answer is 3. How did we got? By considering two elements, 1 and 2. The remaining item is 3. This is one solution. Subset, it's a subset. See, I have written the subset, two subsets here. Two solutions are there. The first subset is 1 comma 2. The second subset is only the item 3. Only the item 3. So this is what is the two solutions. And this is the problem, the sum of subset problem with using backtracking. The sum of subset problem using backtracking. So now, actually, now here you would see one more thing, important thing. You should write the bounding function for this. What is the bounding function? You can ask me. Now here, if you see in this the last part, the level 3, after the level 3, I have written here, see, kill. Kill this node. You can kill this node, this full node. You can kill this node. You can also kill this node, but not this. But you can kill this node. But why I have written like that? Because we know if we calculate that also, it is an extra work. We will not arrive at the solution. That is why I have given kill those nodes. Why? Now, what I am trying to say, you see here, now here, till now, the answer what you got is 3. Okay. Till now, what is the answer you got? See, now if you are in this box, now why this should be killed? Now why this 6 and 0 should be killed? I'll explain you. See, why 6 and 0 should be killed? I'll explain you. Because it is not required to calculate. So students will ask, why sir, it is not required to calculate? See, just I'll tell you. Now here, suppose you are in this box. See, I'm highlighting green color box, the solution box. Now till now, the answer you got, the two items you have selected is 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2. The answer you got is 3. The answer you got is 3. Now, further, proceeding further, the remaining item is 3. So if you add with item 3, so if you add, the sum becomes 6. So 3 plus 3, 6. So 6 is greater than the sum what we require, the sum of the subset. The sum of the subset should not exceed 3. The sum of the subset should not exceed 3. So here 6 is exceeding 3. So why to calculate that child? So that only we have to kill that child. Now, coming here, see, observe this node. Observe this node. 1 and 0. Why did I kill this node? Suppose you see here the answer till now, what is the items I have considered? Only item 1. Oh, how I am saying that? See the arrow mark. Starting from beginning, see the arrow mark. See, with item 1, coming here, without item 2, without item 3. I come to this box. I'll arrive at this box. With item 1, without item 2, without item 3. I come at this box. So what is the items are considered till now? Only 1. If I considered only items are only 1. What are the remaining items? 0. Then why to calculate this child, right hand side child? Because there is, what are the remaining item weight? 0. So if I add 0 to 1, also the sum equal to 3, I will not get. So why to simply to calculate this child? So it is better to kill this child instead of calculating here. The same rule hold here also. See, 5 is greater than 3. So no need to calculate the child. And 2. 2 is less than 3, but the remaining weight is 0. Whatever I add 0, whatever I don't have any items to add it to 2, so I will not make a sum of 3. So better to kill that child. So last here, the last child also I have given it as kill, because till now I cannot consider any items. Till now I have not considered any items, and there is no remaining items also to add. So better not to calculate that child. So I have written this kill. Now this is actually a bounding function. This is a rule. This is a bounding function. If your sum of the items exceed the subset sum, see the subset sum he has given, find the subset whose sum should be equal to 3. But if you see here, 6 is greater than 3, so kill that. So if you see here, 4 is greater than 3, so kill that. See here, 1 is there, it is less than 3 only. 1 is less than 3, but to make it 3, you don't have any remaining item, so kill it. See here, 1 is less than 3, but you should add at least 2 to make it 3. But you don't have, see, the remaining items are 0. So you don't have anything to add to that item. So kill that child. Here, 5 is greater than 3. So no need of calculating that. So kill that. Here if you see 2 is less than 3. But the remaining item, you see, it is 0. So you don't have anything to add it to 2 to make it 3. So better not to calculate that child only. So kill that. And same way, same it goes for this last child also, so to kill it. Now this is the state space tree for sum of subset problem given the set as 1, 2 and 3, and the sum should be equal to 3. Now the same thing, I'll share one more screen to the students. Okay, just 1 minute. See here, if you see this, I have given a new problem for you. This problem is for assignment. Just try this problem. First time you will go wrong. So item 1 is 5, item 2 is 10, 3, item 4, item 5, item 6. So instead of 3 items, I have given 6 weights. 6 weights are, they will call it as items. 6 weight has been given to you. Now this is a set given to you. Now we want the subset. What is the subset? You want the subset. But how do you proceed to calculate the subset? The subset answer should be 30. The subset answer should be 30. So just tell me one answer that comes with subset answer as 30. Subset 1, for example, you take it as 12, 18. This is one subset. Subset 2, what you can take? 10, 13, 12 and 5. This is one subset. Okay. Next, what subset you can take?
15, 10, 5.
Correct. 15, 10, 5. This is one subset. But here we are directly finding out. But this actually students should solve this using a state space tree, which I have shown it for taking a simple diagram. Simple example only was so much difficult, you would have observed. So much child tree and all we got. Just assume this little more difficult problem. So they will also give simple problem only in exam, but this is little difficult problem which I have given to students. So let them try. So you try, take your own time, try it. I will share this. Now whatever Excel sheet I have explained, I will share this. Using that, try to find. If you don't get, I will also try to solve and come out with the state space tree. Okay. Now next, Here, these are the two bounding functions. These are the two bounding functions. This is left hand side is one bounding function. Right hand side is one bounding function. Now, what is this bounding function is? It is the rules which have to be, which we need to follow. Why we need to follow? Now, in the last Excel sheet, I told few childs I am killing it because I am not getting the no need to calculate those child. Even if I calculate, it is a waste for me. Which were those child? I will tell you here. See, again I will share that sheet one more time. Neatly, you see here the child 6, 0, the child 4, 0, 5, 0, and see, these are all killed by one bounding function. If you see here, I have written kill. Here also kill. Here also kill. These are all killed by one bounding function. Why means? Even if we calculate, 6 is greater than 3, 4 is greater than 3, 5 is greater than 3. So those are all killed by one type of rule. When the sum is greater than 3, when the sum is greater than 3, these childs are killed by one bounding function. You can calculate. No need, nothing problem in it. But for making the algorithm speed and working faster, no need of calculating these extra child. If you calculate also, not a problem. Not a problem. Okay. Now, this the other childs are, if the answer is 1 and there is no remaining nothing to add, and if the answer is 2 and if nothing is there to add, if the answer is 0 and there is nothing to add, then also you kill it. That is using by one more bounding function. When the value is less than 3. When the value is less than 3. Now see here, I'll show that. Coming to again the Word document. Coming to your Word document, see there are two bounding functions. One, kill the child when the sum of the values are less than or equal to m. M is nothing but, for the last problem, what did we consider? M is equal to 3. So why m is equal to 3? Then we got two subset, that is 1, 2, and one more subset, that is 3. These are the two subset, and the set is 1, 2, 3. From this set, we calculated two subsets, but on the condition m is equal to 3. The sum of the subset should be 3. So now, this summation symbol, what you see here, summation of I is equal to 1 to k w I x I. What is that is, I'll write it in English statement. Just see here, summation of w I x I means what is, it tells that the items or weights considered till now. This is the English expansion for that. Summation of wi comma wi xi for I is equal to 1 to k means the items considered till now. That is the English statement for that. Plus the weight of next remaining item. What is the meaning is? The items or weights considered till now plus the weight of the next remaining item. If that sum is greater than 3, for our example, is less than 3, for our example, then no need to calculate that child. Because when the items considered till now plus the weight of the remaining item gives you a value that is less than 3, then no need to calculate that child. What is the meaning of that is, we are not going to calculate the subset's answer like this and all. No need for us. This two subsets are not needed for us. Not needed. Why means, if you see this subset 1, the answer is 1. It's also a subset, but the condition is it is less than 3. Now, this is also one subset, 2. 2 also is one subset. Now that we need that subset, no, it is not required. Why? Means that subset sum is less than 3. So this 2 also are actually valid subsets of this set, but actually it is not needed because the value of those 2 are less than m. Now one more, what are the other subsets? 3. The other subset is 3 plus 2, it is 5. One more subset is 6. Any other subsets you have got? If you, no. 1 and 2, if you take 1 and 3, you can take 1 and 3, this is one subset. 4, you can take 3 and 2, you can take 3 and 2, and these two are also subset. But do we require this subset? Also, these are valid subsets of the set 1 comma 2 comma 3. But if you find the sum of that, 1 plus 3 gives the answer as 4, and 3 plus 2 gives the answer as 5, which is greater than m. What is m here? For our problem, it is 3. So no need to calculate those subset also. That is what is the second bounding function. That is the rule. Second bounding function. What is it is telling is summation of wi xi. If the weights considered till now plus summation of wi, the remaining weights. What I will tell you the English expansion of that. The weights considered till now plus the sum of the remaining weights. If it is greater than the m, then also kill that child. So if you also calculate this subset 1 comma 3, 3 comma 2, you can calculate. But ultimately at last you will come to know that it is not needed. So before only you can kill that child. That is what is this answer. Now for the set, finally I'll conclude it. For the set 1 comma 2 comma 3, totally there are so many subsets. See here, one subset is this one. One more subset is this one. One more subset is this one. So totally there are for the set, totally for the set 1 comma 2 comma 3, there are so many subsets. Now in this, for our condition, for m is equal to 3, I will highlight with a color, only these are the valid ones, that is these two. Only these two are the valid ones. These are also proper subsets, but it is not needed for us because the sum is not coming to 3. That is what is the actual problem. Students, that is what is the actual problem. Now I will be sharing this in WhatsApp. Try to calculate for this problem. Try to calculate this. And if you have any doubts, even I will calculate the state space tree for this problem and share it with you by 2 to 3 days. By 2-3 days, I will share it with you. One more important thing what I want to tell the students is, coming Wednesday, 13th of May, I have given a test for you. So what I have planned, I have given 3 question papers. Very, very simple. I have made very, very simple for the students. 3 question papers I have given. Each question paper contains 4 questions only. I have given all the note with the question paper only. You can read it and come out with any doubts if you have. Each question paper contains 4 questions. In that 3 question paper, at next Wednesday, you have got 12 o'clock class you have got. At 11:55, I'll start the Google classroom as well as Zoom meeting. Both I will start. So now what you do? You join with the Google classroom. Okay. And what I will do, 11:55, I'll tell you which question paper you should start writing. It can be question paper 1, question paper 2, or question paper 3. Anything I can do. So you, that time I'll tell which question paper, you start writing that question paper in a Word or in a paper. You start writing it. If you do it in Word, send the same PDF of that to the Google Classroom. If you are writing it in pen and pencil, take a photo of that, share the same thing to the Google Classroom. This one you should do next week, coming 13th. If any other test is being assigned, please tell those teachers, or I'll also tell them, 13th, there is a test assigned, algorithm test. Okay? And daily I'll be reminding you by putting a WhatsApp message that 13th is your test, coming Wednesday, 12 o'clock. Okay, students? So then, now any more doubts, anytime you